residencies at the Beacon Theater for years, and they do like 2 weeks of shows, and I got invited to be a guest on several of them, and there it was a cool thing to be part of, and I got to go to, they didn't have any guests the very last show that they did. They invited everybody that sat in over the years that could make it, and we all sat in the balcony, and we got to see the last Allman Brothers show. And first time I saw the Allman Brothers was with Dwayne, you know, at the warehouse in New Orleans when I was 16 or something like that. But and I met Dickie Betts very early on, just because I was in Nashville and he hung out there a lot, and he and Susanna and Guy were friends. You know, they're it's done now. You know, Butch is gone, and now Greg's gone. And all great bands are great bands in the long run because of songs. It's all about songs. I mean, you know, it doesn't matter. People talk about, you know, rock and roll bands, jam bands, grunge bands. You know, Nirvana's Nirvana because Kurt Cobain was a really, really great songwriter. You know, that's what separated that band from everybody else that was around. And Led Zeppelin had great songs. Some of them they wrote, some of them they stole, but they had great songs. And, that was just on the first album. But, and they went back and they credit those people later. But, Greg's gone, and I hope I can do this justice. I've never played it before, but Greg Allman, you know, it turned out, you know, when his brother was gone, this band was known for its instrumental prowess. It's the Allman Brothers are the Allman Brothers because Greg wrote really great songs, and Dickie Betts wrote great songs later on. But Greg did it from day one. So